folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist with Camping World, and today we're going to go over the 2018 Thor Ace 30.4. This is an awesome couples model, has a great layout, good for conversation, you get a full wall slide here, and you get your standard queen bed in the back. So all around, definitely a well laid out floor plan. Let's start off right over here. So one of the things I love when manufacturers do in any RV is give you a campsite dinette. The reason I say that, folks, is this is where you'll be sitting, eating your morning breakfast, having your morning cup of coffee. You want to be able to look out your window to your campsite, not out at your neighbor's. So I like when they're able to put it on the campsite here. The dinette itself is also comfortable. You'll see they went ahead and wrapped the back around. So if you want to put your back up against here and have your legs, kind of come across, you're able to do that, which again is nice if you're having conversation with anyone sitting on the sofa, which I'll show you in a little bit. You also have a couple seat belts here, so you can have two additional riders. You have cup holders there in the table, so your travelers, your passengers, can put their drinks right in there so they're not spilling all over. And if you need additional sleeping space, folks, this does drop down into a bed. It's a dream-style dinette, so what that means is there's a little lever right here. You just flip that lever over. That will allow you to push the table down. There's another cushion I have in the back you throw on top of there. That creates your sleeping space. If you need to do some work on the road, you can put your little home office right here too. You'll see an electrical outlet built in right down there, so you have a place to plug in your laptop, tablet, or whatever else you need. You'll also notice easy access storage on this side right here. Just swing the door open like so, and you are in. As I mentioned a moment ago, big window right there, so you can take a look out to your campsite. Up top, you have a couple LED lights to give you a lot of light. One of the things you'll notice with all Thor products in general, and same thing here in the Ace, it's very well lit. So at night, you don't feel closed in and claustrophobic. It is nice and bright for you. Going across the top here, we have a bunch of storage. This first one actually contains your Blu-ray player. So if you want to watch a movie, you can pop it in right there. There is an HDMI cable that's run to your TV already. So that way, again, you just throw the movie in and you're all set. You'll see it is strut assisted there, which is great. So that way it's easy one-hand operation. This is the Brazilian cherry wood right here with the Arctic Frost 2 interior. If we take a look over to the side, this is where the TV is located. And I like that they put it here. It's on an angle. Granted, you won't be able to see it from this seat here, but you can see it on the other side of the dinette. And the main idea is you're able to see it from the sofa. The other cool thing is when we go up to the cab, both the passenger and driver seats do swivel around, as you'd expect in a Class A, so you can sit there and still have a good view to the TV as well. If we take a quick look at the ceiling, you'll notice a couple things. There are two ACs. You have one right up front here, another one in the back, so it'll stay nice and cool on those hot days. As I mentioned, LED lights throughout here. You have a max air fan right here too, so that way if you need to just get some air moving through here and you don't want to turn the AC on, open a couple windows up, turn that guy on, it'll suck the air right out of here, which is pretty darn cool. If you take a look over at the slide, as I mentioned, it's pretty much a full wall slide here, folks. It goes from your living area into the kitchen and a little bit into the bedroom there as well. This, of course, is your jackknife sofa. You have two more additional seat belts here, again, for two additional riders. And the jackknife also does fold down into a bed, lifts up, folds right down, as you would expect. You can see there are heat ducts that are run into the front here, so that way this main living area gets nice and warm. But if you want to carefully place some items on the side, you still can use that as storage. Right up top here, you will notice you have some cup holders, again, for those passengers. Another large window here to let in natural light. Underneath the cabinets, not only do you have LED lights here, you also have an electrical outlet and your speaker. So that way, if you want to jam out, listen to some music, you can definitely do so on the sofa. Lift this up, same thing as the other side, strut supported here for one-hand operation, and that is storage going all across. Then we move into the kitchen. So sometimes with manufacturers, it's the little things that I pick up on and the things I really appreciate. And this right here is one of them, the side rail. Doesn't seem like a huge deal. It's so simple. But having the sink so close to your sofa, the last thing in the world you want is to have a bunch of water run off from your sink top onto your sofa or down in between where you can't get at it. So this right here will prevent it. So I love the fact that they put that in there. Again, you know, it is thinking of the end user. You have the high-rise pull-out faucet here to make washing and rinsing dishes nice and easy. And then you have a single stainless steel bowl. The thing about this bowl, though, folks, is it is very deep. This makes it really easy if you have to wash big pots and pans. You can actually set them down in there. Again, another window for natural light. You'll see this one actually has a roller shade in here instead of your standard blind, so upgraded shade there. Again, LED lights. Right up top here, you'll notice you have two shelves. These are adjustable shelves. There's one kind of hiding right down here, but you can pick that up, and then you can put those wherever you want. Again, adjust it to whatever you decide you want to put in there. Microwave over to the side, fully functional hood right underneath with a light and fan. And then as you'd expect, underneath your hood is your cooktop. It is a recessed cooktop with a cover. That way you can utilize this as prep space. When you need to use it, you just fold this up and back. You see the three burners there. Then the glass sash actually doubles the backsplash too. You have the much more decorative one behind it, but having a double doesn't hurt. Plus the glass is pretty easy to clean. And then underneath the cooktop, you'll see there you have an oven in case you want to do some baking. As far as storage underneath, you have a little bit of storage right there underneath the oven. A couple of drawers right here in the center. Yeah, they are full extension ball bearing. Top two are going to be the same size. This third one here is a little bit deeper. So if you have some larger items in there, you know, I like to take a hand blender sometimes or an apple core. And they tend to be a little bit thicker. They don't fit very well in normal drawers. It will fit pretty easy in there. And then right over here, we'll open that up. If you take a look, you see you have plenty of room there for cleaning chemicals. They also give you not one, but two trash cans. So that way you don't have to empty out your trash nearly as often, which is cool because, you know, obviously they can't fit a residential size trash can in here. So having the two helps make up for that a little bit. Moving over a little further, you get into the Norcold fridge freezer combo here. You have good space in there. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. I also like the fact that your thermostat is right here on the outside, so it is easy to get at. Right next to that is your pantry. This kind of rounds out your kitchen space. So you have some storage up top, two additional pull-out drawers right down below. This is great for like some canned goods or maybe like a box of Pop-Tart, something like that. Just nice and easy to get at. And then as we finish out the slide, this actually gets into the bedroom space. So this is one of three wardrobes in here, folks. They have lots of space to hang clothes, which I really like, because more and more people are looking to spend more and more time in an RV. You know, when you start getting into the almost $100,000 range or slightly over, you know that at that price point, you wanna make sure you're getting your use out of it. So chances are you'll be taking longer trips. Having the space to hang your clothes is definitely important. Underneath that, you'll see three drawers there as well. The bottom one, again, being nice and big. You can see how deep that is. So definitely some good drawer space right through there. Then as we step into the bedroom itself, you have a window on both sides. So that way, you know, you can have some cross ventilation. Also really brightens up the bedroom here during the day. Right in the center is your queen bed. This cushion is the cushion that goes on top of the dinette. You know, I just have it here because I wanted to be able to show it to you. But again, you can store it wherever. So that is the cushion, so you can make that into a sleeping space. But queen bed here. So for those of you that like, you know, some of the smaller Class A's, but you don't want a slide-out bed, then this is the floor plan for you. You have the fixed bed here. On both sides, you see you have some different storage there. This one has a really cool nightstand. It's kind of double tiered. You have electrical outlets there. You have charging ports. You have HDMI port. I mean, everything is just kind of hanging out right there. So that way you can charge all your devices and you still have plenty of room for a glass of water or anything else you need to put there. Right underneath, you have a drawer. You have drawers on both sides. And up top, you have mirrored wardrobes. So again, more space to hang your clothes. You have a wardrobe on that side as well as this one. Again, as I mentioned, three wardrobes in the RV here. Opening up the top, additional storage there. And lights and, again, speakers underneath. And those speakers will be controlled by this unit right over here. You can see this guy. It is Bluetooth capable there. And up above is your TV. So if you want to watch some TV before bed, you have the capability to do that as well. If we take a look at the bathroom, you'll see right here in the back of the door, you have your triple towel holder. And as you go in the bathroom itself, you'll see it is nice and spacious. Big bathroom, the large neo-angle shower here in the corner. The doors are in the roller tracks. That way when you open them, the water goes right down into the shower pan instead of the floor. You have a hand wand in there, shelf space as well. Over to the side, look at this, folks. You have a little linen closet tucked away right here. One thing this bathroom does not lack on is storage. As we go through it, you'll see there's a ton of storage in here. This is just one of several storage spaces. over to the side right here, you see your sink top and vanity. You have the stainless steel bowl there. You'll also notice a little bit of storage underneath. Toilet paper holder is already installed, and it is nice and close to your foot flush lever porcelain toilet right down here. If we take a look up above, you'll see you have, again, more storage. As I said, a ton of storage throughout here. You have the hand towel ring there and storage going across the top. As we take a look at the cab up front, one of the things Thor has done a really good job on in their Class A's is provide extra sleeping space without having it a terrible look. You know, you can take a look right up top here. You'll see you have this bed that is tucked away. Now, this bed is only 250 pounds. If you're looking for something a little bit more where you can sleep two people, you'll probably want to look at something like the Freedom Traveler where it goes up to 500. But either way, this is still a great bed for a couple children, or if you want to sleep in one adult up here, you can certainly do that. And it is easy to drop down. It's a power switch that's located right over here. So you just turn the key to on, turn the switch on, you can raise and lower it there. You'll also notice across the front, you have some storage right up here. You kind of have these nets, so easy access. Great place to store some papers, you know, just stuff some envelopes in there, whatever. You have storage on both sides too. Again, these ones give you a little more room, but they use the same nets just to make it easily accessible. Now, if we drop down here, we'll take a look right in the center. So you'll see that they kind of have this almost wood grain dash, which is pretty cool. You know, it kind of gives it that luxury feel, if you will. And you have plenty of outlets. You'll see you have a 12 volt on either side here. Right in the center, you have a USB port as well as an HDMI port. The cool thing about that HDMI port, folks, is this right here. If you look at your main head unit, this unit is touchscreen, as you can see. One of the things you will see is dual mirror. So what you can do is you can take your cell phone, plug a cable into your cell phone, plug it into that HDMI port, and whatever is on your screen will pop up on that center head unit. That is awesome for using GPS. You can essentially use Google Maps, which is a free GPS system. If we take a look over to right underneath, rather, you'll see you have this mat in the center, which is great for wallet keys, something like that, some cup holders there. And take a look at the shroud right here. This is going to be fiberglass, and they didn't carpet it. Most manufacturers do, and I think that's a huge mistake, because right here on the corners, it gets all dirty as you move in. You get mud and stuff all over it, and the carpet's hard to get clean. This is super easy to clean, folks. Plus, there's a neoprene layer underneath, which helps reduce some of the engine noise. If we take a look over at the driver's seat, you'll definitely be spending some time in here. You definitely have a plush seat, so it is quite comfortable. Again, this does spin around, as does your passenger seat. If we look over to the armrest here, you will see auto level. That's right, folks, it has auto level on there. Touch a button, you're good to go. Cup holder there as well. You also have powered heated mirrors. You can see you have emergency start up on the dash, so if you need to borrow the house batteries to start the coach, you can do that. And if we take a look over at the passenger side, one of the neat things is this right here. This actually folds over, and take a look at this. You have a nice workstation. So if your passenger needs to work on laptop, tablet, something like that, or maybe just eat a snack, they can do that. If you need a place to plug in your electronics, you have your standard plug-in right over here, and then a 12 volt right across the way. With the slide in, you'll see you do still have a walkway all the way back to the bedroom. You have enough room to be able to get into the bathroom here. And you can also get into the refrigerator. Now that we've seen the insides, take a quick look at some of the outside features on the 2018 Thor Ace 30.4. Starting off, folks, this one is built on the Ford F-18 chassis with the Ford V10. You'll see the windshield isn't quite as big as your normal Class A, but that's not a bad thing. It still gives you great visibility, and it's just less chance that you'll get a rock chip in the windshield itself. You have wet windshield wipers, so that way as you're keeping it clean and it's spraying, it keeps the whole windshield clean there for you, so you have great visibility. Speaking of visibility, when we come around to the side, you have bi-directional mirrors here with side view cameras. So that way, when you put your turn signal on, you can see the side here to make sure it covers your blind spot so you don't sideswipe anyone as you're switching lanes. Right down here is a pretty neat feature too, folks. This is a little doggy window. So if you have loved ones, little furry friends that come with you, they can lay right here and be able to see outside as well. can see there's a large power awning on here. Just touch a button to have that roll out. Same thing to have it go right back in. It does have an LED light strip on there. And one of the coolest things about this particular setup is if you look underneath the awning, you will see there's not any vents on this side. You also don't have any slides impeding this space. So this whole thing right here is great usable camp space. You see the window right here I had mentioned? This is right where your dinette is. You'll notice they're frameless windows, so that's cool. That way, not only do they look nicer, but also the seals are tucked behind the glass. They're not getting as beat up by the elements. And because the way they tilt open, it also allows you to have them open while it's raining so it doesn't get all stuffy in the coach. You still have some great airflow going through. You see the grab handle right here, so it's nice and easy to enter. Power step there as well. You open it up, you see the step comes right down. Inside, you do have a couple things. You have a step light. Cool thing about that is, you know, if you want to shut the rest of the coach down, you can just leave that on so you can see when you're entering or exiting at night. You'll also see you have a little pull-out tray right here, which is pretty cool. You can see that guy. Then you have this side compartment right over here too. Also, you'll notice right here, you have more storage. You kind of have that running along the back of the dinette right there. So not a ton, but it's a little something extra there. Fire extinguisher by the door. Hopefully you never have to use that. We take a look right down below here. We'll open it up, look at some of the storage. So you have the rotocast bins here, which is pretty cool because this won't rust on you. You get water in here, no big deal. You want to stick a coolant in there, it leaks, who cares? You have a drain plug right down there to drain it all out. You'll also notice up top you have a little bit of a pass-through, so that way if you have really long items like skis or something that you want to slide in there, you can do that. Making our way down a little further, open this one up. You'll see you have your two batteries right here. Right next to that, folks, this is your hydraulic pump. Cool thing about this and something that Thor does a really good job on is troubleshooting and maintenance. You'll see all these lines are color coordinated. That way, if you have to troubleshoot it, you know exactly where that line goes. You can also manually, for instance, move the jacks. So if you need to do that, you can pop this end cap off, put a hex head in there, and you can actually be able to turn those so that way you're not stuck out in the middle of nowhere. Right here, you have your electrical outlet. Need to plug something in outside, that's the place to do it. Couple outside speakers in case you want to listen to music outside. And if watching TV is more your speed, you have an outside entertainment center right here too. So that way you can watch the game or whatever. And again, that is underneath the awning, which should help provide shade so you don't get all the glare from the sun. More storage right over here. You can see that. Another cool thing, let's say you want to cook outside. One of the things they do that's really neat is they have a separate door for your propane quick connect. Rather than having it stuffed underneath the coach or somewhere where it's hard to reach, you have this own your own little compartment right here that we can hook your grill up, grill out, watch the game. You can be you know, the cool guy at the campground, make everyone else jealous. You do have a little bit of storage right underneath here. This is one of your tanks. One of the things that Thor does as well is on the outside of the tank here, you'll have this plate. If you remove this plate, you can get to the sensors on your tanks. You can see the wires right here. The neat thing about that, folks, is it does make them a lot easier to change. So in the event that you're getting bad readings on your tanks, it's easier to change out. If you plan on doing some boondocking, you want to fill your freshwater tanks, that'll be the place to do it right there. And as you come along the back, my favorite part about this floor plan on the outside is this right here. Folks, this is massive storage for a Class A of this length. This is really, really cool. I love how much storage you have back here. You'll see you have a holding spot for your ladder. That's to be able to reach the top bunk inside above the cab. You also have your table and leg out here. That table sets up right in between that driver and passenger seat. Again, those both swivel. Just gives you an extra place where you can, you know, eat a meal, play a game of cards or whatever. But folks, that is a huge storage area right back there. So we take a look at the back here. You have a rear mounted ladder so you can quickly and easily climb up onto the fully walkable roof. And if you look right in the center there at the top, you will notice your backup camera. That way you can back up nice and easy without hitting anything. Rear fuel fill allows you to fill up from a pump on either side. So even if you're over here, you know, on the driver's side, you can still fill up. You're on the passenger side, you can fill up there too. Really doesn't matter. Great place to have it. Underneath, you have a 5,000 pound hitch. So if you want to tow anything behind you, you can do that. And as we come around to the other side here, this is the same storage, just the other side. You can see again, big storage compartment in there, two lights. One of the things you'll notice as we go throughout is all your storage areas have lights in them, which is pretty great. Cummins Onan 5,500 watt generator. Folks, this makes it pretty self-sufficient. You need to run AC, you don't have shore power, turn that generator on. You can do whatever you need. 50 amp power cord there for shore power, cable plug-in, city water inlet, water heater right here. This is something else I like that Thor does. If you notice, it's color matched. A lot of times it's just like a big white or black plate on a lot of manufacturers. They color matched it, put the decals into it. It looks very seamless. So I love that they did that. Kind of gives that almost full paint look to it, right? Especially with the HD Max on here. It looks really good. We open this up right down underneath. You'll see you have an outside shower there. Again, you have a light in case you're accessing at night. You also have a black tank flush if you need to wash out your black tank. And moving on a little bit further, here's your termination, both your black and gray tank valve. You'll also see your water pump right next to that, folks. Again, trying to make troubleshooting easy for you. Coming up to another storage, you have storage right here. You see this little box? That controls that full wall slide. Folks, in the event that that full wall slide doesn't go in, you can unplug a couple plugs on there, allow you to manually push the slide in. There's also a button, you can push that 6 times, it'll flash a code. So that way if you need to call in for some troubleshooting, you can do that too. If you take a look at the top of the slide, speaking of that, you'll see there's a slide out topper on here. That way any pine cones or anything that fall, just stay right on top of that topper so you can put it in without having any fear of sticks or pine cones, acorns, anything else getting in and buggering up your seals. And then right here, of course, is your propane fill. All right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is the 2018 Thor Ace 30.4. If you're interested in this gas Class A and you'd like price and availability, simply click on the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and let's go camping.